Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to solve a question which is based on analytic function. Question is w is equal to sine z and we have to prove that this function is analytic function. So let's see how. Solution. First of all we will write w means function of z and this is equal to sine z. Okay, now what we will do, we will convert this z into x and y, so it will be x plus I y. Okay, now what is sine a plus b formula is, so we will recall the formula sine a plus b and this is equal to sine a cos b plus cos a sine b. Okay, so here value of a is x and value of b is iy. So this is equal to sine x cos iy plus cos x sine iy. Sine x plus iy. Okay, now what is cos iy? Okay, so there is one relation between circular and hyperbolic function, that is cos iy we can write as cos hyperbolic y and sin iy we can write as I sin hyperbolic y. Okay, this is relation between circular and hyperbolic function. Okay, once again if you don't remember this, so cos iy which is equal to cos hyperbolic y and sin iy which is equal to I sin hyperbolic y. You can easily prove this function, like cos theta, you know that e raised to power theta plus e raised to power minus theta divided by 2. At the place of theta you can write iy, you will get this value cos hyperbolic y. Okay, so now again this value sin x plus iy will be sin x and this is cos hyperbolic y. At the place of this cos iy we will write cos hyperbolic y plus cos x and sin iy we will write sin hyperbolic y multiplied with I. So, we have separated real part as well as imaginary part, so we will put now u is equal to sin x cos y because this is our real part, and imaginary part v is equal to cos x sin hyperbolic y. Okay, what you have to do, you have to convert this w as u plus iv, where u and v are real function of z. Okay, so here we have u is equal to sin now what we have to do, we have to prove that this function w is equal to sin z satisfied CR equation. Why? Because CR equation is necessary condition to be a function analytic. Okay, so what is CR equation? So CR equation is ux which is equal to vy and uy which is equal to minus of vx. You have to prove both the condition. Okay, ux is equal to vy and uy which is equal to minus of vx. Now u is equal to sin x cos hyperbolic y so u is equal to sin x cos hyperbolic y, then ux means partially differentiation of u with respect to x is equal to cos x cos hyperbolic y. Why? Because when we are doing partially differentiation with respect to x, y variable will be constant. Okay, so it will be cos x cos hyperbolic y. Now what is uy? Uy means partially differentiation with respect to y, so now x will be constant. Okay, so sin x and cos hyperbolic y differentiation is sin hyperbolic y. Okay, there is no negative thing. Cos hyperbolic y is positive sign differentiation and sin hyperbolic y is positive cos. Okay, then again what is v here? So v is equal to cos x sin hyperbolic y, so vx Vx will be cos differentiation, and cos differentiation is minus sin x. Okay, and sin hyperbolic y we will write as it is. And Vy, so Vy will be cos x, and differentiation of sin hyperbolic y is cos hyperbolic y. Okay, now we have to check that Ux is equal to Vy. Okay, so what is Ux? Cos x cos hyperbolic y. What is Vy? Cos x cos hyperbolic y. So we can say that Ux is equal to Vy. And let me check this Uy, which is equal to minus of Vx. Okay, so yes, it is correct. Sin x sin hyperbolic y minus sin x sin hyperbolic y. So since CR equation satisfied, that implies we can say that the function, what is our function, w is equal to sin z, is analytic function. Okay, hence proof. So we will check once again this question. Yes, show that w, which is equal to sin z, is analytic function. So first of all, we have to separate this w in terms of real part and imaginary part. Okay, so first we will put z is equal to x plus iy. Okay, then we separate by using sin a plus b formula, and then we use condition of circular and hyperbolic condition, and then we will separate u and v, then apply CR equation satisfied, then we can say that the function is analytical function. Okay, so thank you so much. I hope you understand this question. We will solve more question in next video. Thank you so much.